Hello students, myself Milan Patel, assistant professor at LG Institute of Engineering and Technology. Today's topic is about classification of groups. So let's begin. These groups can be classified in three types. First is pitched or sloping groups, second is flat or terrace roof, and third is curved roof. The choice of the type of roof will depend mainly on climatic condition, shape of building, availability of materials, and importance of the building. The pitch roofs have sloping top surface and they are useful at places where rainfall or snowfall is heavy. The flat roofs are useful at places where moderate rainfall is there. And the curved roofs have their top surface curved in the form of shells or you can say domes. Okay, so these are the three basic types of the roofs. Now let's see the types of pitch roof first. There are three types of pitch roofs. First is single roof, second is double or purlin roof, and third is curved roof. First we will see single type of pitch roofs. In this type of roofs, common rafters are provided to each slope without any intermediate support. There are total five types of single roofs. First is lintel roof, second is coupled roof, third is coupled closed roof, fourth is collar beam roof, and fifth is collar and scissor roof. First we will see lintel roof. You can clearly see the image of lintel roof. This is the simplest form of pitch roof and it is also known as the pant roof or SL roof. In this type of roof, one wall is carried up sufficiently higher than the other one to give necessary slope to the roof. Okay, you can clearly see one wall is comparatively higher than the second one. The rafters are suitably secured on the wall plates and eaves boards. Battens and roof covering are provided. You can clearly see this in figure. A lintel roof is generally used for sheds, outhouses, attached to main buildings, verandas, etc. It is suitable for maximum span of about 2.4 meter. Okay, so this type of lintel roof is used up to 2.4 meter span. Next type of roof is coupled roof. In this type of roof, the common rafter slope upwards from opposite walls and they meet on ridge piece in the middle. You can clearly see this in figure. The common rafters are firmly secured in position at both ends, one end being on the ridge piece and the other end is at wall plates. Okay, such a roof is not very much favored because it has tendency to spread out at the feet or you can say wall plate. And to push out with force the wall supporting the wall plate. Okay, this type of coupled roof is suitable for span up to 3.6 meter. Okay. Next type of roof is coupled closed roof. This roof is just similar to coupled roof except that the legs of the common rafters are connected by one tie beam. You can clearly see tie beam in coupled closed roof. Okay, the tie beam prevents the tendency of rafters to spread out and thus the danger of overturning of walls is avoided in this case. The tie beam can also be used as ceiling joist when required. This coupled closed roof can be adopted economically up to a span of 4.2 meter. For increased span or for greater loads, the tendency of the rafter to sag in middle can be prevented by providing a central road connecting the ridge piece and the tie beam. Such a member is known as king road or you can say king bolt. Okay. So this type of arrangement is only provided for increased span or for greater loads. Okay. Next type of roof is collar beam roof. This roof is a variation of coupled closed roof. The tie beam is raised and placed at higher levels as shown in figure. You can clearly see tie beam or you can say collar beam is above than the previous one. A tie beam is then known as collar or collar beam. Okay, a collar beam roof is adopted to economize the the space and to increase the height of room. A collar beam is usually fixed at 1/3 to 1/2 the vertical height from the wall to the ridge. The lower is the collar, the stronger is the room. Okay, this roof can be adopted up to a maximum span of 4.8 meter. Okay. And the last type of roof is collar and scissors type of roof. This roof is similar to the collar beam roof, except that two collar beams which are crossing each other to present an appearance of scissors are provided as shown in figure. You can clearly see two collar beams are crossed like this, okay, like a scissor. Such a roof is known as collar and scissor size of roof. Okay, that's all about this single type of pitch roof. Now let's see double or purlin roofs. When the span exceeds about 2.4 meter, the necessary size for the rafters become uneconomical. Hence, in order to reduce the size of rafters, the intermediate supports called purlins are introduced under the rafters. You can clearly see purlins in this image. Okay, each rafter is thus supported at three points. First, at the bottom one, wall through the wall plate. Second, at the top by ridge beam. And third, at the center by upper limb. Okay, the effective span of the rafter is thus nearly much lighter than it would be if span the whole length from eaves to the ridge. Such a roof is known as double or purlin roof, and it can be economically adapted up to a span of 4.8 meter also. Okay, so this is called as double, or you can say purlin roof. And the third type of pitch roof is called as truss roof. When the span exceeds 4.8 meter, when there are no inside supporting walls or partition for the purlins, the frame structure known as trusses. The spacing of trusses depends mainly upon the load on the roof, position of cross walls, span and material of truss. But the spacing is generally 3 meter for wooden trusses. The trusses carry the ridge piece and purlin on which the common rafter is resting. The trusses span in the same direction in which common rafters run. Okay. Thus, the roof in this truss roof system consists of the following three components. First, rafters to support the roofing material. Second, purlins to provide intermediate support to the rafters. And third is trusses to grant support to the end of the purlins. Okay, some of the usual forms of roof trusses are as follows. You can clearly see the seven names of the truss roofs, like king post truss, queen post truss, mansard truss, truncate trusses, Belfast truss, twin trusses, and composite trusses. Okay, let's see one by one. First is king post roof truss. You can clearly see the figure of king post roof truss. In this type of truss, the central post known as king post form support to the tie beam. Okay, this is the central portion is called as king post. Okay, which forms support to the tie beam. The inclined member known as struts prevent the principal rafter from bending the middle portion. Okay, a king post truss is suitable for roofs of span varying from 5 meter up to 8 meter. Okay, suitable joints are provided between the rafters and tie beam, between the principal rafter and king post, between the king post and tie beam, and at the end of struts. Okay, the joints are further strengthened by straps or bolts. Next type of truss is called as queen post truss. This truss differs from king post truss in having two vertical members known as queen post. You can clearly see two queen posts in figure above that. Okay, the upper ends of queen posts are kept in position by means of horizontal member, which is known as a straining beam. You can clearly see straining beam here in queen post. Okay, the straining seal is introduced on the tie beam between the queen post to counteract the thrust of struts. Okay, the additional purlins are also supported on the queen post. This queen post roof truss is suitable for the span varying from 8 meter to 12 meter. So you can clearly see the queen post roof truss have more span compared to queen post roof truss. Okay. Now let's see the combination of king post and queen post roof truss. The convenient combination of king post and queen post trusses can be made to increase the sustainability of queen post truss up to the span of 18 meter also. For this purpose, the queen post truss is strengthened by one more upright member, which is known as princess post on either side. You can clearly see the princess post here in this figure. Okay, both figure shows the line sketches of resulting combination of the king post and queen post trusses. Okay, this is the combination of these two trusses. Third type of truss is mansard truss. This is the image or figure of mansard truss. This truss is named after a French architect called as François Mansard, who designed this truss to satisfy the requirements of municipal laws. Okay, the mansard truss is a two-story truss with upper portion consisting of the king post truss and the lower portion is the portion of queen post. Okay, it is thus a combination of king post and queen post roof trusses. The mansard truss has two pitches. You can clearly see in this figure. Okay, the upper pitch, or you can say king post truss, varies from 30 degree to 40 degree, and the lower pitch, which is the queen post truss, varies from 60 degree to 70 degree. Okay. The use of this mansard truss results in economy of the space, and a room may be provided in the roof between two queen posts. Okay. However, this truss has become obsolete at present, mainly because of its old and ugly appearances, and also due to the introduction of steel trusses. Okay. This figure A shows the detail of mansard roof truss, and figure B shows the line sketches of two alternatives of this mansard truss. Okay, you can also use these alternatives for construction of this mansard truss. Next type of truss is called as truncated truss. This truss is just similar to mansard truss, except that the top is finished with flat with a gentle slope to one side. You can clearly see gentle slope in this figure also. Okay, this is the figure of a line sketch of truncated truss. This truncated truss is used when room is required in the roof. Okay. Next truss is Belfast truss. This truss is in the form of pole. It consists of thin sections of timber with its top cord curved. This truss can be used for long spans of about 30 meter, provided at light roof covering, which is used. Okay, this truss is also sometimes known as a latticed roof truss, or you can say low strength truss. Okay, you can clearly see a light roof covering can be placed above this Belfast truss. Okay. Next is steel trusses. For spans greater than 12 meter, it becomes economical to use this type of steel trusses. The mild steel is easily available in rolled sections of standard shapes and sizes. This facilitates the roof constructions. For small span, the steel trusses consist of angled, riveted, or welded together through plates known as gusseted plates. Okay, as steel can resist both stresses, compression, and tension. Okay, the design of steel truss is simplified. The arrangement and sizes of various members of a steel truss depends mainly on the span, loading, and wind pressure. In our country, the timber has become very costly, except in hilly regions. And hence, the steel truss have practically replaced timber trusses. Okay, this figure shows the various standard form of steel trusses. You can clearly see simple fringe steel truss, which is used for 6 to 9 meter span, hollow steel truss, which is used for 9 to 12 meter span, compound fringe steel truss, which is used for 12 meter to 15 meter span, cambered fink steel truss, which is used for 12 to 15 meter span. You can clearly see one camber in this cambered fink steel truss. Next is Howe steel truss with brace code. Okay. And next is Northern Light steel truss. Okay. Then modified North Light steel truss, bow spring steel truss, and arc steel truss. Okay. These are the various standard forms of steel trusses available in the market. Okay. You can use from these types of trusses. Next truss is composite truss. These trusses are composed of wooden members as well as steel or wrought iron members. The steel is used for members which have to be resist tensile stresses. The typical composite truss is shown in this figure. Okay, you can clearly see there are the portion of steels and there are the portion of number of portion of the wooden members. Okay, it is light in weight compared to steel trusses and also the economical. However, special fittings are requested at the junction of steel and timber. It should be seen that the joints in composite trusses are such that cast or force fittings are easily used. Okay. This is called as composite trusses. That's all about pitch or sloping type of roof. Next is flat or terrace roof. A roof which is nearly flat, which is known as flat roof. It should be noted that no roof can be laid perfectly level. Okay, the roof must slope in one direction or the other to cause rainwater to flow off rapidly and easily. The construction of flat roof is same as that of floors, except that the top surface is made slightly sloping in case of flat roofs. The two types of flat roof which are, first is Madras terrace flat roof and second is Bengal terrace flat roof. First is Madras terrace roof. The procedure of construction of Madras terrace roof is given below. You can clearly see the exact image or figure of Madras terrace roof. First is the teak wood joints are placed on rolled steel joists with a furring piece between the joists and rolled steel joists. The furring is placed sloping and it gives necessary slope to the flat roof. Okay. You can clearly see the furring piece, okay, which is a sloping member. A course of special prepared terrace bricks is laid diagonally across the joists. The size of brick is generally about 150 mm by 75 mm by 25 mm and they are placed on edge in lime mortar. After brick course has set, a course of brick bed concrete is laid. Okay. You can clearly see the layer of brick pack concrete in this figure also. The thickness of this course is about 75 mm and it consists of three parts of brick beds, one part of gravel and sand, and 50% of lime mortar by volume. Okay. Then the concrete is well rained for a period of 3 days and allowed to set. Okay. Then after, the flat tiles are then laid over the layer of concrete. The tiles are laid in two courses, making the thickness of about 50 mm. Alternately, the China mosaic pieces may be used in place of flat tiles. Okay. Finally, the surface of the roof is finished by three coats of plaster as shown in figure. The surface is rubbed and polished and it is given a slope of about 1 in 30. Okay. Here 1 is the vertical portion and 30 is the horizontal portion. Okay. As this type of flat roof construction is widely used in old Madras state, which is in Tamil Nadu, it is known as Madras terrace roof. Okay. So this is how you can construct Madras terrace roof, which is one type of flat roof. Next type of flat roof is Bengal terrace roof. This is how Bengal terrace roof looks like. Now let's see the construction procedure of Bengal terrace roof. First of all, the rafters are placed with slight inclination at 300 mm to 500 mm center to center. One end of the rafter is inserted into the main wall to a depth of 200 mm and its other end is supported on a veranda wall. Or you can say a brass summer. A brass summer is a beam or a lintel which is provided to support a wall over an opening. Okay, a brass summer in turn is supported to over piers or posts. The battens are placed at right angles to the rafters at a center to center distance of about 150 mm. Okay, a course of flat tiles is the laid in mortar over the battens. Finally, the surface of the roof is finished in any one of the following method. First method, two or more courses of flat tiles may be laid and then the surface of roof is rubbed and polished with two or more three coats of plaster. Or second one, a layer of fine jelly concrete may be laid over the first course of tiles. The thickness of this layer of concrete may be 40 mm. On this layer of concrete, another course of flat tiles is laid and the surface of roof is rubbed and polished with two or three coats of plaster. Okay, this is the two methods of the tiling you can say. Okay, as this type of roof is mainly used in Bengal state to cover the verandas, it is known as Bengal terrace roof. Okay, this is how you can construct the Bengal terrace roof. Now let's see what are the advantages of flat roof. The construction of this flat roof is simplified. It is easier to make a flat roof fireproof than a sloping roof. The roof area can be utilized for roof gardens, drying yards, playing, etc. The terrace can conveniently be used for sleeping in hot season or for a celebration of functions. The construction work of upper floors can be easily started in case of these flat roofs. In case of pitch roof, the entire roof is to be removed and is to be replaced by a new roof under such circumstances. It is therefore considered to be the best choice of multi-story buildings. A flat roof is more stable against high winds. It is not necessary to enclose the triangular space in case of flat roof, and hence it leads to the overall improvement in the architectural appearance of the building. A flat roof does not require false ceiling, but in pitch roof, it is desirable. For multi-story buildings, a flat roof is the only choice because overhead water tanks and other services are located on this flat roof, or you can say terrace. A flat roof is found to be overall economical than the pitch roof. Okay, so economy-wise, you can consider flat roof over the pitch roof. Now let's see various disadvantages of flat roof also. A flat roof cannot be used for long spans without the introduction of intermediate pillars or beams. The cracks are developed on the surface of the roof when the variation in the temperature is very high. Okay, the pockets of water are formed on the surface of the roof if the slope is not sufficient. This leads to the leakage of roof, and it sometimes proves to be difficult to exactly locate the position of leakage on this type of roof. At places where rainfall is very high, the flat roofs are not desirable. Okay, the dead weight of the flat roof is considerable, and hence it proves to be more expensive. Its initial cost is very high compared to the pitch roof, because we use RCC members in this flat roof, while in pitch roof, this is constructed with the help of wooden members or the steel members. It is difficult to trace and rectify the leakage in this type of flat roofs. The progress of work in a flat roof is very slow as compared to that of pitch roof. Okay, these are the various disadvantages of the flat roof, or you can say terrace roof. That's all about the flat roof or terrace roof. Now let's say the curved type of roofs. This is how curved roofs look like. There are a number of images as well as the figures are given here. These are just the modification of pitch roof and are frequently employed in modern age, or you can say in recent trends, okay, to cover large areas and to give architectural effects. The shell roofs and domes are varieties of curved roofs. They are useful for big structures such as factories, monumental works, libraries, theaters, recreation centers, etc. These curved roofs may be constructed of timber or RCC. The latter material being very common nowadays in this type of curved roofs. Okay, there are two common forms of these shell roofs. First is north light shell roof, which is shown in this figure, and second is barrel vault shell roof, which is shown here. Okay. A dome is a rounded vault forming a roof. It is useful when roof is to be provided on circular brickwork or regular polygon shaped walls. The curved roof offered pleasing appearances, and in most of the cases, the construction of curved roof result in economy of steel and concrete. Due to arc actions, the stresses are considerably reduced, which results in thin section of curved roofs. It is also provides space in the roof, which can be utilized for some various purposes. A recent development known as doubly curved tile roof has combined the advantage of flat roof and curved roof. So, how you can construct doubly curved tile roof? First of all, the precast units of cement concrete tiles are prepared at the site. The size of this tile kept as 700 mm by 700 mm with a uniform thickness of about 20 mm. These tiles are in the form of domes with a rise of about 50 mm. The cement concrete proportion should be kept as 1 to 4. Here 1 is cement, 2 is the sand, or you can say fine aggregate, and 4th is the coarse aggregate. Okay, this type of proportion is adopted and the units are properly cured. Then after, precast units of these RCC beams are prepared and the reinforcement is provided as per structural design. The dimension of beams are usually about 90 mm deep and 130 mm wide. The stirrups are kept projecting about 50 mm above the precast portion so as to have bond with cast in situ concrete. The cement concrete proportion should be kept as 1 to 4 and the units are properly cured. Then the beams are suitably laid across the supporting walls. Then the tiles are placed in position after spreading some mortar on the edges of beams. The minimum bearings of tiles on beams should be 25 mm and that on walls should be about 50 mm to 70 mm. The haunches between humps of tiles are filled up with cement concrete of proportion 1 to 4. Suitable waterproofing treatment to the roof is given at the top. The roof does exhibit a flat surface at the top and curved surface at the bottom. This is called as doubly curved tile roof. There are various advantages of this doubly curved tile roof. It can be constructed in short time as it affords the advantage of prefabrications. It does not require constant scale supervision and can be easily adopted for the villages. It is cheap in construction and it requires less formwork compared to other type of curved roof trusses. Okay. So that's all about the curved roofs. That's all about the classification of roofs. Thank you for watching.